It feels good to be back, Tyler.
Taylor, it feels great. I gotta tell you what, and it feels great to be an FAU Owl right now.
Let's get us started with some FAU soccer. Of course, our men's team has been doing wonderful this season.
Somebody we haven't brought up is Mr. Jonathan Wallace, our running back, number 27. Oh. This guy is a power back. Mm-hmm. I know this from last year. He did great.
We have been waiting for something to click on offense, and I think that this game, it was it. I'm Taylor Stewart.
And I'm Tyler Tipton.
Okay, this is our last show of the semester.
Let's go Alpha Bang.
Yep, let's do it. Okay, a bunch of news to talk about. FAU football going out on a huge win against our big rival, FIU. What a huge game it was.
Yes.
Our guys played like they had a chip on their shoulder. They won the Shula Bowl trophy.
It feels great, Taylor. I mean, you know, to get the Shula Bowl back here, and after how we lost last year to them, we sat here on the show and we're just like, wow, I cannot believe we just got blew out by FIU. And for us, I mean, we dominated the game too. It wasn't like it was closer or anything. Yeah. And the Shula Bowl is truly ours. I mean, they've only won twice, and we'll talk more about that in the panel, but it feels great to have it back.
Yeah, exactly. And, you know, so many of our seniors had huge games.
Yes.
Which I think is so nice, because if this is the last game, it's important for the senior. It's of course important for everyone to have a good game, but especially for the seniors. What a rough year it has been for them, and so for them to be able to win four straight games and have, we have to shout out a couple players that.
Yeah, absolutely.
Damian Fortner.
Yep.
Corey Henry, Martin Wright.
All huge. All had a huge game against FIU. Mm-hmm. Damian Fortner once again ran for 100 yards. Corey Henry 2.5 sacks.
Martin Wright.
That's Martin Wright. Martin Wright, sacks. Golly, I'll tell you what.
Yeah. And you know what I think was the most exciting thing is FIU was not able to score a touchdown. And that's always good. Of course, it would be nice if they ended up with a big goose egg at the end, but having to settle for field goals,
that's okay.
I'll
we'll take
that any day.
Definitely.
And it was an exciting game. You know, what are your thoughts on moving forward now? If there is a bowl game, do you think that this secured Brian Wright's spot as a head coach here?
You know, it's all going to come down to what Pat Chun is thinking, but if it's me, I say keep Wright. I mean, you know, he's 4-0, and honestly, he hasn't struggled with one game in these four games. They've all been by large margins, okay? I mean, the offense is doing great. He was the offensive coordinator before, and he brought in the offensive line coach and made him the offensive coordinator. And the offense is just stellar. And the thing is, he's working with Jacquez Johnson. He's doing a great job with it, whom Jacquez Johnson was a sophomore this year. So he's got two more years here at FAU. So I would keep him. I would keep him.
And not only the recruiting factor. I mean, how much is it going to hurt us if we start from scratch? And you know, Pelini brought in Brian Wright. He has proven to be a great, great, great recruiter. And so if you're a good recruiter in Florida, especially South Florida, that's where we need to be getting the majority of our players. You know, I'm all about bringing in a big name, but if they don't have ties to South Florida and they're not able to recruit this area in our backyard,
then it's not going to be good.
I don't think it's a success.
Yeah, I mean, everybody knows that, you know, the South Florida area is one of the hottest areas in the country. In the country, not in the state, for recruiting. And I mean, the state of Florida itself, I mean, Central Florida and up north by the, you know, the Georgia border are hot spots as well. This entire state is one of the best states in football, period. You know, right there with Texas, California, Alabama, Ohio. And, you know, Brian Wright, I think that he can continue to recruit within the state and bring great players here.
Yeah, we'll see. I think we're all very anxious to find out our fate, not only with the head coach, but the bowl game.
Yes.
If not, I think the season, do you say it's a success?
Absolutely. Are you kidding me? After the whole Pelini thing and how that happened, for us to go 4-0 after that, that just spells character.
Mm-hmm.
That just spells character. And I'll tell you what, our players have just done a great job this year. Nothing but progress. 2 years ago, 1-10. These players have seen a 1-10 season. These players have seen a 3-8 season. These players have experienced now their third head coach.
Mm-hmm.
The guys pulled it out. They went 4-0, and I tell you what, I couldn't be more proud of the Florida Atlantic football team.
Yeah, they're definitely a resilient bunch, to say the least. And, you know, whether they get a bowl game or not, I think it's deserved. They've done so much, like you said. Just great job to them. Now to some other FAU sports. Women's basketball won.
Speaking of resilience.
Women's basketball won the Thanksgiving Day tournament that they hosted. This is huge for us. You know, this team has really gone to the next level.
Definitely. I tell you what, I was in person at the game, and our girls are feisty. Mm-hmm. The girls from Rhode Island, the opposing team, were a lot bigger than mm-hmm. our girls. I mean, we don't have many girls, you know, over 6 feet. Mm-hmm. They've got at least six, and
wow.
we're talking about girls that are 6'4", stuff like that, like, you know, monsters on the court. But our girls say, hey, it doesn't matter anyway. We're going to continue to shoot, be accurate. And I tell you, I love the way our girls play defense. Our girls get a lot of steals,
mm-hmm, yes.
you know, a lot of takeaways, and they're just real aggressive. I love it.
Yeah, they're exciting to watch because, especially for women's, they get a lot of steals, they even get some blocks, and they score a lot,
yes.
which is always exciting. So, you know, as far as the conference tournament, I mean, they have a lot of experienced seniors. We got a freshman coming off the bench that's a dynamo, doing great. So I think they look really good for the conference. I mean, if we were still in the Sun Belt, no doubt the best team in the conference.
Yes, definitely, definitely. And I think, you know, we could take that in Conference USA, you know,
exactly.
at this rate, mm-hmm. why not?
And so now our men's basketball, of course, has been hitting a rough patch.
The other side of the waffle.
They face UCF this week. You know, we have talent. Is it the coaching staff? Do you think it's a mixture? Is it a building year?
I mean, I got to say, it comes down to coaching. I mean, you know, we got a lot of players that are now here, that were here last year, players that were here 2 years ago, and we're just really inconsistent, and we're not getting the job done. We're not winning, period. And it's not going to get any easier on our schedule.
Yeah, having one win in the season, that is not acceptable.
No.
I mean, that is just, if Jarvis has a job, I honestly will be shocked at the end of the season.
Unless the winning, you know, starts now and
yeah,
continues.
Yeah, even if it starts now, it's going to be hard to get in the double digits, get wins in the double digits. I mean,
yeah.
you know, when you start off and you go on a huge losing streak, it's hard to recover from that.
Yeah, seriously.
So hopefully we can, you know, change some things up, whether that's players, coaches, both. Hopefully next year will be a better season for basketball.
Definitely. Well, folks, stick with us. We're going to get into some interesting debates on the panel about BCS standings and other FAU news. So stick with us. We'll be right back.